Hi guys, welcome back to GP Reactions. I hope you're well, I hope you're having a great day. And as always, thanks to everybody that's subscribed. So I'm going to be listening to a track that I'm pretty sure I've never heard before. And it's from a band that I thought I knew a little bit better. And it's called Slowmotion and it's from Ultravox. So a little bit confused by these because I've got a couple of different stats. One is that this entered the UK Top 40 on the 28th of March 1981, peaking at number 33. But it comes from the album Systems of Romance, and that was from 1978. So am I thinking that by the time it entered the UK Top 40 in 1981, was it re-recorded with Midgeur? Because this actual performance looks like it's got John Fox on vocals, and of course this is from the old grey whistle test from, I think it looks like the 5th of December 1978, it's either that or the 12th of May 1978. So Ultravox back then consisted of Warren Cann on drums, rhythm guitar, rhythm machine and vocals, Chris Cross on bass, synths and vocals, Billy Currie on keyboards and violin, of course John Fox on vocals and Robin Simon on guitar and vocals. Indeed, Slowmotion was written by John Fox and Chris Cross. Now I think this performance combines the track Slowmotion and Hiroshima, so I will stop it where I think Slowmotion ends. I've seen Slowmotion up as another old grey whistle test track, and it's about three minutes 40 if I remember correctly, so around about 3:40 mark is where I'll stop the video. But I'm really looking forward to this. I've heard a couple of John Fox songs. I even reacted to a John Fox song, I think it's called either Secret Garden or The Garden. That was really cool, very atmospheric. So it'd be interesting to see how he performs as part of Ultravox. Without further ado, this is Ultravox with Slowmotion.
And now to the second studio band tonight. They are John Fox vocals,
Billy on the old grey whistle test, of course, violin,
Robin Simon lead guitar, Warren Cann drums, and Chris Cross bass guitar and synthesizer. They've had three albums released, the latest being Systems of Romance, and the band has found itself hugely popular in Europe. They're with us in the studio tonight to play firstly Slowmotion. It's...
Thanks, Annie. That could have saved me about 30 seconds of going through the band. You've sort of just done that for me. Thank you.
Ultravox.
Why do you do it all night? Step inside, listen to me.
So I'm just going to pause it there. I just really wanted to say that I can sense a lot of influences here on this album. I think this is their second album, or second or third album. But yeah, I kind of like, if I was to close my eyes and imagine Gary Numan singing this, then that wouldn't be much of a step to take. But also I can sort of sense that there's like the Kraftwerk element of it. And of course, synths were very experimental, and Kraftwerk were the great band that inspired a lot of synth-led bands like OMD, and they were such a great influence, really. So it doesn't surprise me that I'm sort of picking up little elements of those. It feels a little bit new wave as well, but then maybe that's just a guitar. I'm really liking how this sounds. I love John Fox's voice within the structure of Ultravox, and I'm not sure why he left or whether they left him, but I'm sure somebody might out there might know about the history of why he was no longer with Ultravox and why Midgeur stepped up. So yeah, this is great. It's very interesting as well. I'm sorry to pause it, by the way. Okay, right, I think that's where Slow Motion stops, so I'm going to stop it there and just talk about the song as it is. Yeah, really interesting. I wasn't really listening to the lyrics, but the track itself had a really interesting set. I love the guitar. I think that may have been Robin Simon on guitar, and of course you had Billy Curry on the keys as well, and not discounting the bass as well, which was really, really cool. I mean this was a great sound. I'm really, really surprised that, because I mean, for me, Ultravox sort of began with Vienna back in the day, and that's when I first kind of heard the sound, but I didn't really realize that there was a history before that. So this is really, really cool track. I'm going to just jump into the lyrics, because like I said, I wasn't really listening to lyrics. I was more absorbed with the overall sound of the music. So lyrics go, no reply. I'm trying hard to somehow frame a reply. Pictures, I've got pictures and I run them in my head. When I can't sleep at night, looking out at the white world and the moon, I feel a soft exchange take place, merging with people on the brains. This doesn't sound right. Whirling my face in conversation. Slow motion, slow motion. Hush, you can feel the trees so far away. Hush, you can feel the breeze on another day. When we held each other close in the night, while we wheeled away in our own light. Stepping sideways into our own time, such a simple way. Slow motion, slow motion. And we held each other close in the night, while we wheeled away in our own light. So, I mean, the only thing I can really sort of draw from this is that it's about just listening to your own memories, and memories are like a snapshot of life. And sometimes we kind of replay our memories in slow motion over and over again. Sometimes they're memories of the same thing but cobbled together. And I think ultimately the memories are never exactly the same as the moment you lived them in. I remember a series called Black Mirror, I think it was a Channel 4 thing, where everybody who's born has like an implant, and you record everything you ever experience, like visually and or audibly, and everything is recorded. So and that's, you can play that back. I guess that would be fantastic in a terrible thing, as the case may be in a show. But eventually people were taking out implants so they didn't have to rerun these memories. And really that's all I can take from it. That's just my interpretation of what I've just read. But good song, really, really good song. And it does make me kind of curious now to look into maybe what else they were experimenting with music-wise back then in 78. So guys, any thoughts about this? And perhaps the next track, Hiroshima Monomore, may be something I should be listening to as well. I didn't really want to listen to them together, but I don't mind listening to that other one as a separate reaction. So please join me in the comments below. Let me know what you think and feel about this song. Is there any nostalgia there for you? Do you remember seeing Ultravox when they had John Fox as their lead vocalist? Till next time, take care of yourselves, have a great day, have a great week.